Okay. I'm ready. What do you think?
Oh, you look...
I know, don't. I know what I look like. You haven't seen me in a bathing suit in 20 years.
Don't you remember that first day? That's how you look.
Well, thank you. But what first day?
The first day at the beach. When you were swimming out too far and the riptide was pulling you under.
Oh, sure. Yeah, well, I'm lucky that you were so close.
Luck had nothing to do with it. I was staring at you all afternoon, wondering whether I had seen you before or wished that I had. And afterwards, when we talked, you must have noticed how I was staring.
No, because I was too worried that you might notice I was staring at you.
You know, it was weeks afterwards that I realized that I knew your face from your movies.
Well, I didn't think it was important enough to mention.
You did mention other things. And we stayed on the beach until the sun came down, remember?
Mm-hmm.
Discovering that we had just ended relationships that were so painful. Mine with Pamela and you with... You never mentioned his name. I know now.
Cece, don't. Let's...
Sophia, you are going to witness a rare and momentous occasion. I was wrong. When you came back, I accused you of still seeing Lionel. I was angry, and I was jealous. And it was the first time that I found out that you were... that he was something to you. And I made your life hell for it, and I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. Because there were many times I had the opportunity all those years ago to be honest with you, and for some reason...
Let's not go back that far. There were things back there that were painful to me and to you. Let's try not to take too much at one time. I just want to feel what I'm feeling now. You are to be arrested for treason and murder.
No!
It's so good to hold you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's been terrible. Living so close to you and not being able to touch you, not being able to tell you how much... You see, I'm afraid.
The only thing that I'm afraid of is losing you again.
You see, Gina is your wife.
I know. But we have something apart from that. From everything else in our lives. It's something that we've earned over the years.
There is so much of want and so much I'm afraid to want. I mean, before, when I first came back, I thought if I could just see you, if I could just see you and the children, it would be enough that I would want it more than that. Now the memories just sit back, getting so close. Now I'm afraid I'm going to lose you all again.
Sophia.
Cece? Oh my, Cece? Well, I want you to just hold very still. Well, you hold still, and I'm going to go and get some help.
Oh, wait. I've got to tell you. You have to know.
Tell me what?
I could die any time.
Cece, what are you talking about? You're not going to die.
Please listen to me. The doctor has told me that I have an aneurysm in my head. It could happen any time.
No, I don't believe it, but that's not true.
Maybe it's right that I die now, the day that Channing died.
You don't say that.
You know, when I gave birth to him, Sophia, and then we took him away.
it's not you. You were to blame.
Every year since he died, this is the hardest day. It's too hard to go on.
No, you listen to me. You are not going to die. Do you hear me? I am not going to let you die. Our son is gone, but we can't bring him back. So you see, there's nothing we can do, but we have so much to live for. We have our other beautiful children, and we have friends, and darling, we have each other now. We found each other. Do you know what that means? It's a miracle. That's a gift. I love you. I've never stopped loving you. Now, listen, you're not going to die. I can't leave you now.
I love you so much.
Do you? I've been...
always love you, always.
I'm waiting so long to hear those words from you. Susie, I love you. Don't leave me. Don't die, Susie. Please.
Susie? All right, now, darling, I have the number. Now, what is the doctor's name?
Morrison. I don't want him to come to the house.
Cece, why not?
I don't want anyone to know I'm ill.
Oh, Cece, no.
Please, Sophia, listen to me. Do as I say.
Hello, this is an emergency. This is Sophia Capwell. I need to talk to Dr. Morrison immediately. Thank you. The pill I gave you, do you feel any good? You feel fine?
I'm fine. If I tell him that we'll come there.
All right, yes, Dr. Morrison. Cece has collapsed. Yes, he's in terrible pain. I gave him the medication. All right, fine. We'll be there as soon as we can. Thank you very much. How do you feel?
Better. I think the pill, the pill helped. I'm sorry, Sophia.
Sorry? What are you sorry for?
For panicking and frightening you with all that talk about dying.
Oh, no. Now, you listen to me. You don't have to be infallible with me. Do you understand that? When someone is sick, they are frightened. Cece, remember the vows. In sickness and in health.
Did you mean it when you said you loved me?
Did you? All right, let's go to the doctor.